नमस्ते एवरीवन, वेलकम टू द सेकेंड लेक्चर ऑफ मीनिंग ऑब्जेक्टिव एंड टर्मिनोलॉजी ऑफ अकाउंटिंग. इन द लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव सीन व्हाट इज अकाउंटिंग, वी हैव सीन द फीचर्स ऑफ अकाउंटिंग. इन दिस लेक्चर लेट अस स्टार्ट विद द डिस्टिंक्शन बिटवीन बुक कीपिंग एंड अकाउंटिंग. ऑलरेडी वी हैव अंडरस्टूड व्हाट इज बुक कीपिंग एंड अकाउंटिंग. लेट अस डिफरेंशिएट देम based on certain parameters. So based on nature, bookkeeping is the job of bookkeeper. It is a clerical in nature, whereas accounting, it is a job of an accountant and is analytical and imaginative in nature. So nature we have understood, bookkeeping is clerical and accounting is analytical and imaginative. Scope: bookkeeping is concerned mainly with the recording of transactions. So in bookkeeping, what we do, we record all the transactions day by day. Accounting involves classifying, summarizing, analysis and presentation of information. Stage: bookkeeping is the primary stage of maintaining the accounts. Means this is the first step in accounting, maintaining the books. So it is the primary stage. And accounting is the secondary stage of maintaining records. It starts where bookkeeping ends. Results: bookkeeping merely reflect the transactions as they occur and do not provide any conclusion, whereas accounting shows the net result and financial position of the business. Basis: in bookkeeping, the transactions are recorded according to the principle of accountancy, whereas in bookkeeping, accountancy determines its own principle. So here there are certain rules, using those rules we are doing bookkeeping. And in accountancy, so they have their own principles and rules, by that they are recorded. Authority level: the work of bookkeeper is performed by junior staff with a comparative less authority, whereas the work of accountancy is performed by the senior staff having comparatively more authority. So these are the six parameters or six points on the basis of which we can distinguish between bookkeeping and accounting. Bookkeeping and accounting are, however, complementary to each other. Complementary to each other, that means they are depend on each other. Okay, using bookkeeping only we are doing accounting. Bookkeeping provide the basis for accounting because analysis and interpretation are not possible until the transactions are recorded. But without accounting, bookkeeping is meaningless because mere recording the transactions does not show the result of business. Accounting is a generic term and the bookkeeping is an essential part of it. So bookkeeping and accounting, they are related terms, they are dependent on each other. Okay, if we are not doing bookkeeping, we cannot do the later stage part, accounting is not possible if we are not doing bookkeeping. And if we are not doing accounting, then there is no use of bookkeeping. Now let us see the objective of accounting. Objective of accounting means for what we are doing accounting. Reason why we are doing accounting. The main objective of accounting are as follows. First is to maintain record of business. The primary objective of accounting is to maintain a systematic and up-to-date record of all the financial transactions. It involves identifying the transaction of financial nature, measuring them in terms of money, recording them in the books of accounts and classifying them under appropriate heads. This objective of accounting has assumed great importance due to increasing size of business and growing complexity of business transactions. Second, calculation of profit or loss. The first objective is to maintain the record of business, right? So here we are recording all the transactions. which are related with money. Second is calculation of profit or loss. Another main objective of accounting is to ascertain the net result of day-to-day transaction. During a specific period of time, every business firm wanted to know whether it has earned a profit or suffered a loss during a period. For this purpose, a statement called income statement or profit and loss account is prepared. So every business, okay, it wanted to know how much profit it has made, and for that we, from the basis of this bookkeeping, we create income statement or profit and loss account. In this statement, revenue earned and the expenses incurred on a transaction of a period are recorded. So here what we are doing, we are recording total revenue and total expenditure, and by that we understood how much profit or loss we have. A comparison of the two shows net profit or net loss. In addition, information is available about opening and closing stock of the goods. Okay, so along with that, we also know how much stock we have at the start and how much stock we have at the end of the financial year. So it indicates opening and closing stock. Purchase and sales, so we know how much total purchase and sales we have done, and other significant factor leading to profit or loss. Third objective is depiction of financial position. A business firm also wanted to know its financial position at the end of a particular period. For this purpose, a statement called balance sheet is prepared. So along with this profit and loss statement, there is one more statement called balance sheet. It shows the assets, liabilities and capital of the firm. Now we will see these terms in detail afterwards. What are assets, what are liabilities and capital of the firm. A doctor can know the health of a person by feeling his pulse. Similarly, one can know the financial health of the firm by looking at the balance sheet. So by looking at the balance sheet, you can understand the financial health of the company, how the company is. If its assets exceeds the liabilities, the firm is solvent. Otherwise, it is insolvent. So what we say? If the asset exceeds the liabilities, assets are more than liability, then the firm is solvent. Otherwise, it is insolvent. Fourth, to make the information available to various groups and users. Another purpose of accounting is to communicate the financial fact about a firm to various interested parties. Example, owner, investors, creditors, employees, tax authorities, government, research scholars, etc. So to make the information available, so information regarding the business, okay, from bookkeeping, from books of record, okay, these persons will not get much information. So informations in which these authorities are interested, these are the authorities means owners, investors, creditors, employees, tax authorities. So what information they need, all these informations is present in the final account books, that is profit and loss account or balance sheet. On the basis of such information, these users of accounting can take sound and realistic economic decisions. So based on this, these users means everyone have their own interest in the business. So accordingly means owner, if there is owner, then he can take the decision whether he has to make some changes in the business or he have to invest more. Tax persons, they take the decision that whether they have to charge more tax or less tax, like that. So each user, okay, related with business, take a sound decision, okay, based on these accounts. From the study of accounts, the management can know the result of its policies. It can decide upon the future course of action, such as increasing the scale of production, introducing the new product, or changing the selling price, etc. Okay, if the company is making loss, then what they can do? They can increase the price of their product. Lenders and investors can judge the earning capacity of the firm and decide whether or not to lend, invest more money. Now, business, you will see that, and business, it is not the businessman's money involved. Okay, majorly there are many lenders. Lenders means the persons who are having more money, but they don't have a proper idea of business. So what they do, they give their money, okay, to someone who knows how to do business properly. So they are lenders, okay, and they are interested in profit. Means if business is doing good, they will make more profit, and so based on these accounts, they decide whether they have to lend more money, they have to give more money or not. Shareholders can make an estimate of the efficiency of management and decide whether or not to sell their shareholding in the company. And similarly, these shareholders, they can also make an estimate of the efficiency of management and decide whether or not they have to sell their shareholding. The shareholders, who are shareholders, this is later part, okay. Owners need accounting information to know the profitability and financial soundness of the business. Investors want to know the safety of their investment. Creditor require accounting information to assess the credit worthiness and the repaying capacity of the firm. Now, creditors are those who give credit. Who give credit, from whom we are taking loan. So they are also interested in our business. Suppose I am doing a business, okay, and I want more money for expansion or some other purpose, I will go to a bank for a loan. Now that bank will not give me loan, okay, until and unless bank is sure that I can repay. Now when the bank will be sure that I can repay? When my business is good, I am doing profit, right? How the bank will know about all these things? Okay, they will know about all those things based on our accounts, okay, books of account. So bank, that is creditors, are interested in this. Owner himself is interested because owner is doing business. Shareholders are interested. Shareholders are partners of the business, so they are interested whether they remain as shareholder of the company or they sell their shares. So every party is interested in the business, and they know information about all these things based on accounts. So this is one more objective of accounting, okay, to make the information available to various groups and users. Now let us see advantages of accounting. So in objective, we have already seen why it is important. So some advantages there only we have done. Now advantages, first is replacement of memory. Okay, when we are writing everything in the books, then there is no need to remember all these things, right? Replacement of memory. Human memory is limited, and no businessman can remember all his transactions. In accounting, business transactions are recorded properly. Accounting provides a complete record of a financial transactions. It helps to overcome the handicap caused by limitation of human memory. Okay, so in short, replacement of memory means the human being or the person or the businessman need not have to memorize all the transactions what are done, okay, during the year. Second, settlement of tax liability. When the proper accounts are maintained according to the principles of accounting, when proper accounts are maintained according to the principles of accounting, it becomes easy to ascertain the amount of income tax and other tax payable by him. Okay, so this books of account, they help into ascertain to understand how much tax liability the business have, means how much tax the business have to give. okay. Third is legal evidence. Systematic record and accounts are accepted as a documentary evidence in the court of law. Now, in case of some dispute in court, these books of account can be used. So, they are legal evidences. Systematic records and accounts are accepted as documentary evidence. They are accepted as a proof in the court of law. For example, if a businessman wants himself to be declared insolvent. Now, businessman wanted to declare himself insolvent means he wanted to declare that now he have loss in business and now he cannot repay to the creditors. He cannot repay to the banks. He must present his account in the court. So, you start a business, you have taken a loan from the bank, and what happened ki your business not succeeded and you lost your business, means now you are not in position to repay the bank. So you can declare yourself as insolvent. Now for that you have to give the proof in the bank, in the court, that ki now you cannot repay. So in case of insolvency, what happens? Okay, the business becomes or the business is took over by the bank, and whatever loss is there, it was taken by bank. Sale of business. If a businessman wanted to sell his running business, the accounts maintained by him will help in deciding the reasonable value. Otherwise, he may not be able to do, determine and realize the correct value of his business. So, in case you wanted to sell your business, so how much value your business has, that you will come to know based on accounting only. Realization of debts. Accounting help a businessman in realizing money from his debtor. Accounting serve as a proof of debt and he can enforce his claims in the court of law. Now, debt. Okay, as the businessmen take loan from other institutes, okay, in the same way, customers also many time purchase, okay, from you, and they do not pay you on time, means they do not pay when they are purchasing, that is called credit sale. Okay, so they are debtors, means they have to repay money, okay, after some time, right? So after what time, how much money they have to repay, all these things you will come to know from your account. So this accounting is again required for realization of debts. So you can realize your debt, means you can collect money from them, okay, based on your books. Raising loans. In order to borrow fund from the bank and financial institutions, a business firm has to submit its financial accounts. Their lenders carefully screen the financial statement of the firm before granting the loan. So loan, you can get loan from the bank based on your accounts. And comparative study. A systematic record of transaction enable businessmen to compare the correct year's result with those of the previous years and identify the key factors causing the change. The result of one firm can also be compared with those of the other firms of the industry to judge the comparative position of the firm. So comparative study means you can compare your business performance year after year. Okay, so this year's performance you can compare from last year's, from 2 years back, like that. And at the same time, you can compare performance of your business with the business of some other persons. So you can understand whether you are doing business well or not. Okay. Next is assistance to management. Accounting provide valuable informations, financial informations, to the management. Such informations help the management in planning the business activities, in taking correct decisions, and in controlling the business operations to ensure the attainment of goals. For example, cash flow statement is helpful in estimating the future receipt and payment so as to make optimum use of the fund. With the help of accounting information, management can maintain control over expenses and ensure better utilization of assets. So these are all advantages of accounting. Okay, you can go through these advantages 2-3 times so that you learn all these advantages. Next is limitation of accounting. Limitations. First is not fully exact. So accounting, what we are doing, it is not exact. Business transactions are recorded on actual basis, but on many occasions estimates have to be made for calculating profit or loss, deciding the useful life of an asset for depreciation purpose, provision of bad debt and doubtful debt, valuation of stocks are examples of such estimates. Now, what you mean by depreciation, what you mean by doubtful debt, bad debt, okay, all these things we will again see later on. But in short, what I say that when you purchase a machinery, okay, it costs us say 5 lakh rupees, but after some time, after 6 months or 1 year, okay, the value of that machine will not be same, okay, its value will decrease, that is called depreciation. And how much its value decreases, okay, that you predict, okay, actual value though you will understand when you sell it, but year on year you have to make some decrease in its value, that is called depreciation, and it is estimated one. So therefore we say that it is not fully exact. Bad debt means there are some persons who has purchased goods from you, they have not paid on time, and afterwards they don't have money, so they will not pay, that is called bad debt. Okay, so all these information like bad debt and depreciation we have to estimate, so therefore this is not fully exact. All the informations which are present in the books of account, they are not exact. Okay, the estimates may differ from person to person, therefore the amount of profit or loss cannot be treated as absolutely exact. So these estimates, it depends person to person. Some persons will consider more bad debts, some person will consider more depreciation, like that. Second, does not reflect the true worth. In the balance sheet, assets are recorded at cost less depreciation because they are meant for use and not for sale. Therefore, the balance sheet does not show the present worth or market value of the business on a particular date. Does not reflect the true worth. Okay, so what it says that in the balance sheet, assets are recorded at cost less depreciation. So assets, we are how we are recording, we are writing its cost and we are subtracting depreciation because they are meant for use and not for sale. Therefore the balance sheet does not show the present worth or the market value of the business on a particular date. Okay, so day by day we are not subtracting depreciation, we are doing this depreciation after 1 year. So day by day we cannot have the correct value, true worth. Third limitation is incomplete picture. In accounting, only those transactions are recorded which can be expressed in money. Non-monetary transactions such as quality of goods, labor relation, competence of management, loyalty of staff, etc. are not recorded in the books of account. Unless such important factors are kept in mind, it would be very difficult to assess the future of the business firm. Inaccuracy. Accounting state may fail to reflect the correct picture due to errors and fraud, changes in the method of depreciation, valuation of stock, etc. Inaccuracies means while we are recording, we can record things incorrect. Sometimes management deliberately enter wrong figure. Sometimes management himself put wrong figures, okay, give wrong picture to its shareholders, its creditors, artificially inflate or deflate profit. Due to such window dressing, balance sheet fails to show the true and fair view of the financial position. Window dressing means what we are doing, we are not showing correct picture. Okay, we are not showing correct picture means we are not recording correct information. Accounting information is not comparable when different firms follow different methods of depreciation or valuation of work. Okay, so depreciation, as we say, we decrease the value of assets. Now there are various methods of depreciating. Different firms use different method, and therefore we cannot compare them. Sometimes worthless assets such as preliminary expenses, underwriting commissions, discount on issue of shares and debentures, etc., are shown in the balance sheet. Ignoring changing view of money. The purchasing power of money keeps on changing due to inflation or deflation, but accounts and are prepared on the assumption that the value of money is stable. As a result, the quality of accounting information suffers. Okay, so the value of money keep on changing, right? Value of money means the purchasing power of money. So it is varying, but that variation we are not taking into account in accounting. So while we are doing accounting, we are considering that value of money is stable. So these are all limitations of accounting. So I will stop my lecture here. Okay, what we have understood in this lecture, we have understood features of accounting, what are the various features of accounting, why we are doing accounting, the objective of accounting. Second, we have discussed about advantages of accounting and limitations of accounting. Now, all these points you have to learn, you have to remember. Okay, so again, go through all these points. And if you find any topic difficult, call me and discuss with me. Thank you. Thank you for watching this video.